Well, welcome back to Steve Rod Reviews. Today, we're going to start on part three of the solar tower build. And I got some hinges. I was over at Pig Iron, and I found these, and I thought, you know what? I can make them work. Take a look at these babies here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a bolt through here. You can see how that's going to be there. And a couple of washers. And we're going to see if we can fire this in. I've got the pole out in the back of my truck. And yeah, I'm going to bring that in here too. But the first thing we got to do, no more hankering around. We got to get some concrete in the bottom of this post when I put it in the ground. So this is what we're going to do first. We'll get the plasma cutter out. I'm going to show you exactly what I got planned for getting the concrete inside this post and making it more secure. So let's get to it right now. There you go, right there. You can see the shape of the outline that I'm going to plasma cut out. First thing we got to do, buzz through a hole. There we go. That way there, when I put my tip, my plasma cutter here, I don't have to actually pierce my way through. It's a lot easier on the machine. And then I'll just go all the way around. But I got two holes. So let's take a look at the other one. Yeah, I got one at the other end of the pipe too. So I'm going to put two holes in and I'll give you a better look later. But let's get drilling this hole. Okay, let's get the plasma cutter out and let's buzz these two holes out. Okay, you ready? So this steel, for those just new to the channel, just watching for the first time, I'll put the other two episodes of how I made this in the link below. But this is 5/16. And I got the plasma cutter set for warp drive. So let's go and let's get this cut. Well, I'll just show you the two cuts here, and that's pretty well it. I haven't touched this yet with the grinder, but I'm going to just grind that off a bit there. Then we'll move down to this one. I made this one just a tad bigger, and that's pretty well it there, guys. And I'll just get my little grinder and grind off the edge there. Okay, so what we're going to do next, we're going to bring in that big pole, set it all up, and show you how it's not such a big pole anymore. I first started out with saying I was going to get a 12-footer. Guys, plan B. Okay, you guys take a look at that crack right there. And you can see where the two pieces meet. And you let me know when they just join up there and it's nice and flush. Must be getting close right about, oh, back too much. Maybe right about there. Well, if you guys are wondering how I was moving that pipe and how I was getting this all set up, guys, this is just a little scissor jack, and it's so easy to adjust just at the end here. This is a great addition for the shop. So let's take a look at this pipe here, and let's see what we're going to do with it. So what are we looking at here? Well, we're looking at that hinge, and the only way I can figure to put this hinge on is to put a bolt in it, tighten it up, put it on a flat desk, got on a sheet of steel here. I got my straight edge. Guys, I think this is going to be about the best I could do. I like to get this set up first before I bring it over to the spot to get welded. So let's go over to the beam and let's see how this is going to fit over there. Well, here's the main beam here, and I decided to go with a 6.5 footer. I'll explain that in the future. But here we go here. I shimmed it on both sides with some 1/4 inch. I'm going to have to put something here to stop this from going back and forth this way. So I'll shim that up there. That'll be no problem. And here's the setup right here. And yeah, so she's all ready to go. All I have to do is ticky-tacky this together. There's the shot right there. So what I like to do is sand it all first, and then I actually put some acetone on there to clean it up really good. The only problem I have with a setup like this, and I've run into this before, because them angles aren't perfect, guys. And what happens a lot of times, she wants to bind. It doesn't want to come up right, and it binds. So I don't know what's going to happen here, but I'm just going to put a couple of ticky-tacks in there, and we're going to see how she goes. And hopefully it lifts right up and it doesn't bind. So let's tack this up first. Okay, guys, was I having a senior moment there or what? I had this all rigged up, turned the camera on, flipped the switch on the welder, and I thought, hold it there, buddy. Like, what are you doing there? I couldn't believe it. I thought, okay, time to sit down, have a cold beer, and relax. Because that wasn't going nowhere. Don't pay attention to this part here. Oh my God, that was something pathetic or what? I thought, wow. I mean, you see how you could just go right off the deep end real quick there. So that was pretty close. Okay, let's go on to plan C now. And see what I'm going to rig up here, because I bring you back next time. This pole is going to be done. Not the whole thing, just the pole part. Scrap this idea. Oh boy, it come this close, guys. This close. I wonder how many of you guys are looking at that saying, hold a second, that won't work. Okay, come back again. Okay, part 4, we're going to get more done, hopefully. Hope you guys enjoyed this. If you haven't seen this channel before, well, you're in for a treat. Come back again. Let's have some more fun. Cheers, guys. Man, that was too much.